Okay, good morning students. In today's class we will discuss operational amplifiers. That is the second part of the third unit of basic electrical and electronics engineering. So now in this class we will see what is an operational amplifier and what are the different types of an operational amplifiers and the ideal characteristics of the operational amplifier. Okay, first we will see what is an operational amplifier definition. Okay, an operational amplifier is a linear active device with a differential input and a single ended output. Okay, that is the simple definition. Operational amplifier is a linear active device with a single differential input. Okay, differential input and a single ended output. So these two are the important words, right? So and this operational amplifier is also known as op amp. So therefore, an operational amplifier is a linear device, linear active device. So with a differential input, generally most of the times you'll have a two inputs and single output, single ended output. Okay, that is a simple definition of an operational amplifier. Now, after that we will see symbolic representation of operational amplifiers. So there are two different symbolic representations are there. One is the single input, single output. So in the operational amplifier, you have a single input where you apply the input signal and you get a single output. And in addition to these two input and output, we have a supply terminals. Okay, we have a positive supply terminal and negative supply terminal, and this is the supply voltage VS. And other symbolic representation is, so you have a two different input terminals, VI1 and VI2, and one output is there. Okay, the difference between these two is, we have two outputs here and a single, two inputs and single output. Here, single input and single output. Supply voltage is common for both, right? We have a VS supply voltage here, here also VS is there. Okay, the supply voltage provides a supply to the operational amplifier. Okay, op amp, operational amplifier, in short, is also known as op amp. Okay, so the first two letters of operational and the first three letters of the second word. Okay, operational amplifier. Okay, this is a symbolic representation. So operational amplifier is represented by a small triangle like this, which will have a generally single input, single output symbol, and also two input, single output. Two inputs is known as differential input. Okay, this is a VI1 and VI2. Two inputs are there and single output is present here. Now, and that is why see dual input op amp. Dual input op amp, and this is a single input operational amplifier. Okay? And after that, so now we discuss about dual input operational amplifiers in detail. So practically, this inside the op amp we have a like this, a input resistance RI. RI is called input resistance. Okay, RI is input resistance. Input impedance or input resistance. And so VI1 is the inverting input terminal. Inverting input terminal. Okay, inverting means minus sign. Inverting input terminal. And VI2 is the second input. That is a non-inverting input terminal. Non-inverting input terminal. Non-inverting means plus. Inverting terminal means minus. And in between these two, we apply the input voltage. Okay, we apply the input voltage. And at the output side, you have a gain, that is AV, that is the voltage gain. And R0 is the output impedance. Okay, R0 is the output impedance. Output. OP means output impedance. Okay, R0 is the output impedance and RI is the input impedance and VI is the difference voltage, input difference, VI1, VI2, and AV is the voltage gain and R0 is the output impedance. We apply the input here and we take the output. So this is also an example or in detail circuit of the dual input operational amplifier. So where, so VI is so the difference of these two, okay, VI2 minus VI1. Now you see what is the relation between output voltage V0 and input voltage VI. Okay, the output voltage is VI
VI2 minus VI1. VI2 is the non-inverting input terminal voltage and VI1 is the inverting terminal input voltage. VI1 is the inverting input terminal voltage and VI2 is the non-inverting input terminal voltage. So therefore, output voltage is equal to voltage gain times of VI2 minus VI1. So what the important point to observe here is VI2 minus VI1. So therefore, this operational amplifier provides a gain of AV for the difference input voltage VI2 minus VI1. Okay, so that is why it is also known as differential amplifier. So the differential amplifier means it amplifies the differential input voltage, that is nothing but VI2 minus VI1. It takes the difference, you have to take the difference VI2 minus VI1, that is the difference voltage, and the difference voltage is multiplied by the gain of the operational amplifier AV. Okay, so this is how. So here we get V0 or V0, that V0 is equal to AV times AV is what? That is the gain of the operational amplifier. The gain of the operational amplifier into the difference voltage VI2 minus VI1. Okay, so therefore the difference voltage is multiplied by the voltage gain AV. So therefore this is an important formula to get the output voltage of any differential amplifier. So in the most of the cases we will use a two inputs and single output variation, that is the dual input op amps. Okay, in the dual input op amp we will use a two inputs and single output. Okay, now we will see the characteristics of an ideal operational amplifier. Okay, so first there are some, we have discussed about 5 ideal characteristics of an operational amplifier. The first one is voltage gain. Voltage gain means, so voltage gain is represented by AV. AV for voltage, A for gain. Voltage gain, that is output voltage divided by input voltage. Okay, V0 by VI. V0 is the output voltage and VI is the input voltage. So that voltage gain of the ideal operational amplifier is infinite, ideally infinite. Practically it has a very large value of 20,000, 30,000, like that. So ideal voltage gain is infinite for an operational amplifier. In the same way, so suppose you want to find out in terms of the decibels, voltage gain in decibels, so 20 log AV, so that base 10, actually you have to take a base 10, 20 log AV base 10. So therefore 20 log AV means voltage gain, that is the V0 by VIN in terms of dB, decibels. Okay, the voltage gain, ideal voltage gain is infinity, that is the first characteristics. And the input impedance, input impedance means input voltage divided, it is the ratio of input voltage to the input current. Suppose say if you have an operational amplifier like this, operational amplifier minus plus, and so we say that this is the input. Suppose the current which is passing here, that is the input current, and voltage we apply here between these two terminals is the input voltage. So the ratio of voltage to the current, especially specifically input voltage to the input current, is the impedance. That impedance must be infinite. So for an ideal operational amplifier, the input impedance is always infinity. In the same way, output impedance is zero. The output impedance of the, so output side, this is the output side. So at the output, the impedance must be zero for an ideal operational amplifier. Same way bandwidth, bandwidth means it's the band of frequencies over which the gain of the amplifier is constant. That is called, so bandwidth of the operational amplifier. The bandwidth of the operational amplifier, ideally it is infinite, which means, so infinite bandwidth means over infinite number of frequencies you can operate the operational amplifier without any change in the gain. And coming to the last one, offset voltage of the operational amplifier VI0 is 0. Okay, offset voltage means without applying any input you will not get the output, which means for a noise voltage also you will get 0. So there is no output until unless you apply the input. That is what is called offset voltage, and that offset voltage is 0 in the operational amplifier. So these are the 5 ideal characteristics of an operational amplifier, and these are very important from exam point of view. Too many times you got for 2 marks question. Okay, so this question is, this topic, especially this five points are very important. So that is the ideal characteristics of an operational amplifier and characteristics of an ideal operational amplifier. Op amp means already told you operational amplifier. Now coming to the basic forms of operational amplifier. Okay, basic forms of operational amplifier. There are two basic types of operational amplifiers are there. One is the inverting inverting operational amplifier and non-inverting operational amplifier. So first we will see what is an inverting amplifier and what is a non-inverting amplifier. So inverting amplifier, so this minus sign is there. If you apply the input, see here Vi means input voltage. This input voltage is connected to the negative terminal, and this negative terminal is also known as inverting terminal. Okay, so this is the inverting terminal. So this terminal is the inverting terminal of the operational amplifier. And so if you connect this input to the inverting terminal, it is called inverting operational amplifier. Okay, and positive is grounded. So if you apply the input to the negative terminal of the operational amplifier, that is called inverting op amp. Okay, now we will see what is the relation between output and input, and also we will see what is the gain, voltage gain of this operational amplifier. Okay, generally we have some gain here. That gain, practically ideally the gain is infinite. Now, so before going to analyze this, we have to see what is the Kirchhoff's current law. So what Kirchhoff's current law is, sum of the currents entering a particular point is equal to the currents leaving at that from that point. So entering currents is equal to leaving currents at any particular node or any particular branch. Okay, now coming to this, see here, ideal operational amplifier means no current enters into the operational amplifier. So therefore, here the current is 0, I is equal to 0, and also here I is equal to 0. No current enters into the operational amplifier. So that is a very important point to understand. So current, whatever the current that comes here, it goes into this branch, it does not go into the operational amplifier. In the same way, here even if you connect some voltage source, that current does not go inside of the operational amplifier. So that is one of the important point about the operational amplifier. And also, this inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal, they are virtually grounded. Okay, there is a concept, virtual ground concept is there in operational amplifier. What that virtual ground concept says simply is, so the inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal, electrically they are short circuited, physically they are separated, but electrically they are short circuited, which means whatever the voltage is present here, same voltage is available at this point. They are virtually grounded. Okay, this virtual ground concept and current, zero current enters into the operational amplifier, these two points are important in order to analyze the any operational amplifier. Okay, now what we do is in order to find out the output voltage, so we have to apply KCL at this point. Okay, so therefore, so example you see, so you consider this as some V voltage across this terminal, non-inverting terminal, right? So apply KCL at non-inverting terminal. Inverting terminal. Okay. So we'll apply the KCL at this point. So if you apply that V, so this voltage minus this voltage means, see what KCL says is, so currents leaving from this point and also sum of the currents leaving at this point is equal to sum of the leaving currents at this point. So therefore V minus VI, so this is the voltage across this inverting terminal, that voltage minus the input voltage divided by RI plus, so V, this point at this point the voltage is V minus output node. We take this one V naught by, this is RF feedback resistor, and it is equal to 0. Okay, so this is very simple equation, KCL equation. Apply KCL here, V minus VI by R, you be called voltage by current, voltage by resistance is equal to current. V minus V I am taking outgoing currents. V minus V I by R plus V minus V naught by R F is equal to zero. And so we'll see from virtual ground concept or virtual short circuit concept. So V is equal to zero. Okay, this is important. V is equal to zero means, so no current is entering into the operational amplifier. Whatever the current is coming, that current goes in this path. Okay, therefore, no current enters into the operational amplifier. So therefore, the voltage, whatever the voltage is present here, the voltage is available here. So therefore, this is a ground. This is a ground. Ground means 0 volts. Ground means zero. Same 0 volts appear here. So that is why we say that from virtual VGC means virtual ground concept, V is equal to zero. When V is equal to zero, and if you substitute that V is equal to zero in this equation, then what happens is 0 minus V is 0, V I divided by R I is equal to plus V is equal to 0 minus V naught by R F is equal to 0. Okay, now I will remove this again. I will write it. Now if you simplify that, if you simplify this, what you will get? So V naught minus V naught divided by RF is equal to, if you bring it, so this term into the right hand side, V naught by RF it becomes, and it is equal to minus VI by RI. So therefore V naught is equal to minus RF by RI into VI. Okay, this is the equation for output. This is the equation for output. Suppose see, V naught is equal to minus RF by RI into VI. VI is what? Input voltage. V naught is the output voltage. The output voltage is equal to, so minus of RF by RI into VI. And suppose if you want gain, voltage gain. What is voltage gain? V zero, V naught by VI. So therefore, V naught by VI. If you bring it this VI this side, it becomes minus RF by RI. Okay, this is the voltage gain. Okay, voltage gain, and this is output voltage. Output voltage. Generally, we get the questions on this. There are the equation for output voltage or voltage gain. Now we will understand a little bit about this. See, suppose, so this minus sign indicates that there is a phase difference between the input voltage and output voltage. Suppose if the input voltage, VA is equal to some 2 sin omega t. If the input voltage is 2 sin omega t, so then what you will get output voltage? Output voltage V naught is equal to minus RF by RI into 2 sin omega t. VA is 2 sin omega t. Suppose you assume that RF is equal to 2 ohms or 2 kilo ohms, like this, 2 kilo ohms, and RI is equal to 1 kilo ohm. Now what happens? What is V naught? V naught is equal to minus 2 kilo ohm, this is a 2 kilo, divided by 1 kilo ohm into, what is VA? VA is 2 sin omega t. So then what it becomes? So this kilo ohm and kilo ohm will get cancelled. Minus 2 into 2. V naught is equal to minus 4 sin omega naught t. Minus 4 sin omega naught t. Minus 2 into 2 is minus 4 sin omega naught t. So therefore now you see, what is the input voltage? Input voltage is 2 sin omega naught t. 2 sin omega t. Output voltage is minus 4 sin omega naught t. What are the changes between input and output? So one is the phase reversal of minus 180 degrees. 180 degrees phase reversal. Because here plus sign is there, here minus sign, which indicates between the input and output there is a 180 degree phase difference is there. And also for the input the amplitude is 2 volts. Here the amplitude is 4 volts, which means amplified. So that is why it is called inverting amplifier. Inverting amplifier means, so for the inverting terminal we apply the input voltage and we get the output voltage. The output voltage is modified or amplified version of the input, and also phase difference minus 4 will have a phase difference of minus Rf minus sign with Rf by Ri, where Rf by Ri is the gain. So generally most of the times Rf is greater than Ri, so that is why we get the gain in the amplitude of the output signal. So V0 is equal to minus 4 sin omega naught t. So finally we have to get this output. Okay.
Now we will discuss ideal non-inverting operational amplifier as a second form of the operational amplifier. So in the ideal non-inverting amplifier, we apply the input to the positive terminal. Positive terminal is also known as non-inverting amplifier or non-inverting input. Okay. So we apply the input to the positive terminal and we take the output generally at the output side of the operational amplifier. Okay. Now because we are applying the input to the positive terminal of the operational amplifier, now, in this amplifier also we have to derive the equation for the output voltage and also voltage gain. So, as already we have discussed, first we have to apply the KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, at the, so this particular terminal. Now, see, apply KCL, Kirchhoff's current law. KCL means Kirchhoff's current law. So, KCL at Vin. Okay? And already I told you, the input currents, the currents input to the operational amplifier is always zero, and also this positive terminal and negative terminal are virtually short circuited. That is also called virtual ground concept. Because of this virtual ground concept, and also currents enter into the operational amplifier both are zero. That is why we say that this is an ideal operational amplifier. So if you apply the Kirchhoff's current law at this point, at this terminal, now what we can do is, whatever the voltage is present here, same voltage is available here. Okay? So now, so we apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law here. So therefore, current law at this point. So therefore, so Vin divided by R1. Okay? See, this Vin divided by R1 plus Vin minus V0 output voltage, Vin minus V0 by R2 is equal to 0. Okay, see this Vin minus V0 by R2 plus Vin by R2, because this is the ground. If even if you want, you can write Vin minus 0, because this is the ground. Vin minus 0 by R1. Okay, I am ignoring this, so directly that's why I am writing Vin by R1, Vin by R1. So therefore, if you simplify this, what it becomes? Vin minus V0 by R plus and it is equal to, so this is repeated. Okay, now what we do is, see Vin by R, now Vin by R1, and see this Vin by R2 is equal to, and I will write separately, V0 by R2 is equal to 0. This is equal to 0. Now you take V0 outside, right side, V0 by R2 is equal to, so V in by R1 plus V in by R2, R1. Now V0 is equal to V into, so this R2 and R2 will get cancelled, 1 plus R2 by R1. So therefore this is the equation for output voltage. Here
the point what we have to observe is previously in the inverting amplifier case we got minus sign here. V naught is equal to minus V in Rf by Ri. Here we are getting plus sign. That is why V naught is equal to V in into 1 plus R2 by R1. So therefore, so here the input voltage is multiplied by 1 plus R2 by R1. Example, if R2 is 2 kilo ohm and R1 is 1 kilo ohm, then what happens is it is multiplied by 3. If both these two R1 and R2 are equal, example R1 is 1 kilo ohm, R2 is also 1 kilo ohm, then what happens is, example you see here, right? So input to output, suppose if R2 is equal to R1 is equal to 1 kilo ohm, in that case output voltage V0 is equal to Vin into 1 plus 1. It is V0 is equal to 2 types of input voltage. Here positive sign is there in the output also. That is why we say that it is a non-inverting amplifier. And coming to the gain, output voltage divided by input voltage. In this case, output divided by input is equal to 1 plus R2 by R1. 1 plus R2 by R1. So this is the expression for voltage gain. Voltage gain, expression for voltage gain, and this is the expression for output voltage. Okay, so briefly I will go to that. See, input current is 0 amperes and whatever the voltage is present here, same voltage is present because the virtual is short circuited. So inverting, non-inverting terminal and inverting terminals both are virtually short circuited, and current entering into the operational amplifier is 0. Because of these two, we can apply Kirchhoff's current law because this is an ideal operational amplifier. Once if you apply that, so input voltage minus 0 because ground is there, 0 divided by R1 plus input voltage minus output voltage divided by R2 is equal to 0. So this is how to apply Kirchhoff's current law at the required terminal. Then if you just if you manipulate it, Vin by R1 plus Vin by R2 minus V0 by R2, splitting this term into two terms. So therefore, and if you bring this V0 outside, like this side separately, because we need V0, V0 is equal to Vin into 1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R1, and if you take this R2 other side, then it comes in this way, and finally we will get the output expression V0 is equal to Vin into 1 plus R2 by R1. This is the output equation, output voltage equation, and gain formula is 1 plus R2 by R1 is equal to V0 by Vin. And already I told you, if you make these two are equal, R2 is equal to R1 is equal to 1 kilo ohm, in that case, so output voltage is twice of the input voltage. Suppose if you apply input is at 2 volts, output you get 4 volts. So like that, whatever the same we have seen in the just before a problem, same thing repeats here, but the main difference is there is no negative sign in the output. See, we don't have any negative sign. Previously in the inverting amplifier, we have a negative sign in the output of the output expression. Okay, that is the major difference. Okay, that's the that is the end of the so different types of different forms of inverting and non-inverting amplifiers of a normal operational amplifier. Thank you.